Chapter 2, Limits. Introduction. Chapter 2 explores the concept of limits and its importance in calculus. It discusses how limits are used to find instantaneous velocity and to calculate the area under a curve. The chapter also introduces the concept of secant lines and their relationship to average velocity. Additionally, the chapter covers the squeeze theorem, continuity, and the precise definition of a limit. Learning objectives. By the end of this chapter, you should be able to 1. Understand the concept of limits and their role in calculus. 2. Calculate the average velocity of a function over a given time interval. 3. Use secant lines to approximate the rate of change of a function. 4. Apply the squeeze theorem to find the limit of a function. 5. Determine the continuity of a function at a given point. 6. Define and evaluate one-sided limits. 7. Apply the precise Epsilon-Delta definition of a limit. Key points. Limits are used to find instantaneous velocity and to calculate the area under a curve. Average velocity can be calculated by finding the slope of a secant line. The squeeze theorem allows you to find the limit of a function if it is bounded by two other functions with known limits. Continuity of a function requires it to be defined at a point, have a limit at that point, and have the value of the function equal to the limit at that point. Discontinuities can be classified as removable, jump, or infinite. The composite function theorem states that if a function is continuous at a point and another function has a limit at that point, then the composite function also has a limit at that point. The intermediate value theorem guarantees that if a function is continuous over a closed interval, it takes on every value between the values at its endpoints. The Epsilon-Delta definition of a limit provides a rigorous mathematical definition for the intuitive notion of a limit. One-sided limits can be defined and evaluated using a modified version of the Epsilon-Delta definition. Real-world application. Limits and calculus have numerous real-world applications. For example, in physics, limits are used to calculate the instantaneous velocity of an object at a given time. This is crucial for understanding the motion of objects in the real world, such as the velocity of a car at a specific moment or the speed of a falling object. Calculating the area under a curve using limits is also important in various fields, such as economics, where it can be used to determine the total revenue or cost of a business over a specific time period. Additionally, the concept of continuity is essential in engineering, where it is used to ensure the smooth operation of systems and prevent abrupt changes or disruptions. Conclusion. Chapter 2 of the calculus textbook introduces the concept of limits and its applications in calculus. It explores how limits are used to find instantaneous velocity and to calculate the area under a curve. The chapter also discusses the relationship between secant lines and average velocity, as well as the squeeze theorem, continuity, and the precise definition of a limit. By understanding these concepts, you will be able to solve real-world problems involving motion, calculate important quantities in various fields, and ensure the smooth operation of systems. Limits play a crucial role in calculus and provide a foundation for more advanced mathematical concepts.